Welcome back students to our geometry class, chapter 1, similarity, practice set 1.3, part 1. Yes, this practice set 1.3 we are going to study in two parts, and this is the first video of practice set 1.3. Okay, so students, before we start with practice set 1.3, let us study about similar triangles and the test of similarity of triangles. In the beginning of the lesson, I explained to you all what is similar triangle. So what are similar triangles? The triangles whose angles are congruent but the sides are in proportion. Okay, so if given triangle ABC and triangle DEF, if triangle ABC given similar to triangle DEF, this is a symbol for similarity. So if triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, then we can write that the angles are congruent. That is, angle A congruent to angle D, angle B congruent to angle E, and angle C congruent to angle F. And what about the sides? In similar triangles, the sides are in proportion. So if I take of this triangle ABC, that is AB upon DE is equal to AC, that is this AC upon DF, which is equal to BC upon EF. This is very important. You should know that in similar triangles, the angles are congruent and the sides are in proportion. And this is the way of writing the sides are in proportion. Okay. Now, after this we study the test of similarity of triangles. In earlier standards, you must have studied about the test of congruency. Okay. And there you must have studied some test. For example, SSS test, SAS test, ASA test. In similarity also we have three tests. That is AAA test. A stands for angle and S stands for side. So AAA test, which is also said as AA test. I will explain you later why. Then SAS test, that is side, angle, side. And the third is side, side, side test. Okay. Now, in our textbook, they have explained us about these tests. So we look at our textbook on page number 16. You will see on page number 16, they have explained us the AAA test, that is, given two triangles, we can say that these two triangles are similar by AAA test if the three angles of one triangle are congruent to the three angles of other triangle. For example, in this figure here now, triangle ABC and triangle PQR, if angle A congruent to angle P, angle B congruent to angle Q, and angle C congruent to angle R, then we can say that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR by AAA test of similarity. Okay, they have also mentioned here, you will see. Okay, And it is very important that whenever you write the names of the triangles, it should be in one-to-one correspondence. Always keep a habit of writing the name of the triangles in one-to-one correspondence. Okay. So triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR by AAA test of similarity. Okay. Now, as I said that there is one more test, that is AA test, which is similar to AAA test. Now, what do we mean by AA test? In AAA test, we prove that the three angles of one triangle are congruent to the three angles of other triangle. So, when you are going to solve such type of question, even if you know any two angles of a triangle are congruent to the other two angles of a triangle, it is understood that the third angle is also congruent to the third angle of the other triangle. And therefore, even if you know any two angles are congruent, you can say that, or you can state that the triangles are similar by AA test. Okay? So, here itself, they have also given more information about the AAA test on page number 17 of your textbook. Okay, so you all can go through it. Now, the second test, that is the SAS test. What happens in SAS test? We know these are similar triangles. So here the sides should be in proportion. The angles are congruent, but the sides should be in proportion. So when one angle is between the two other sides and those two other sides are in proportion with the sides of another triangle, then we can say that the triangles are similar by SAS test. We'll see how. For example, triangle KLM and triangle RST. If KL upon RS is equal to LM upon ST. Okay. They have also given the value here, the length here, so that we can prove that yes, KL upon RS and LM upon ST, they are equal to 2 upon 3. Okay. You all can calculate and you can see here. And between these two sides, there should be the angle. Between the two sides, the angle. Then only you can say SAS test of similarity. If this angle is somewhere else, for example, if this angle is here, this angle congruent to this angle is given, you cannot say that the triangles are similar by SAS test. So for SAS test, the angle has to be in between the two sides which show proportion to the sides of the other triangle. Okay. And the next is SSS test for similarity of triangles. Now the SSS itself tells us that side, side and side. So the three sides of one triangle must be in proportion with the three sides of another triangle. Okay. If such condition is there, then we can say that the two triangles are similar by SSS test for similarity. Okay. After this, we will study the properties of similar triangles. Students, you have studied about the properties of congruent triangles in 9th standard. That is the reflexivity, symmetry and transitivity. So, what are these properties in similar triangles? Just let us see. So look here. Properties of similar triangles. The first property is reflexivity. What is reflexivity? Now, reflexivity means a given triangle. Here the triangle given is ABC. Is similar to its own self. So, triangle ABC is similar to triangle ABC. Then second is symmetry. What is symmetry? Symmetry says that if one triangle is similar to another triangle, then that second triangle is similar to the first triangle. So in this case, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, then triangle DEF is similar to triangle ABC. So here, triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF, then triangle DEF is also similar to triangle ABC. This is symmetry. That one triangle is similar to the another, so that another triangle is similar to the first one. And the third property is transitivity. So what is transitivity? Here we have three triangles. If the first triangle is similar to the second, and if second is similar to the third, then the first is similar to the third. So in this case, if triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF and triangle DEF similar to triangle GHI, then we can say that what is the first triangle? ABC similar to GHI. Okay? So, if the first triangle is similar to the second and second is similar to the third, then the first is similar to the third. Okay? I hope you are clear with these three properties of similar triangle, and it is also given on page number 18 of your textbook. Okay, so with this we move to our practice set. Practice set 1.3. The first sum. In figure 1.55, angle ABC is 75 degree. Angle EDC is 75 degree. State which two triangles are similar and by which test. Also write the similarity of these two triangles by a proper one-to-one correspondence. So, the first question we will answer, state which two triangles are similar, and then we have to answer by which test. Now look at the figure, students. If you look at the figure, A, B, C is one triangle here, okay, and triangle E, D, C. Okay, so in these two triangles here, they have given angle B as 75 degree for the triangle ABC and angle EDC 75 degree for triangle EDC. Now, looking at these two triangles, we can prove these two triangles by which test? Just now we studied the different test for similarity. So we have AAA test, which is also AA test. Then we have SAS test and we have SSS test. Now we don't know anything about these sides. So we cannot go for SAS or SSS test. So let's try whether we can prove the triangles are similar by AAA test or AA. As I said, even if you don't know all the three angles, whether they are congruent, any two angles you know that they are congruent, you can say that the triangles are similar. Okay, so let's start. First, we'll write the names of the triangle. As I've told you, Try to write the names of the triangle always by one-to-one correspondence. Now here, if I name the first triangle as triangle ABC. Okay? Then when I write the name of the second triangle, I have to be very careful. So if you look at the second triangle here, this EDC or DEC, whatever, but what will be the correct name for ABC? If I have written ABC, you will see here that B angle here, this angle is congruent to this angle, which is the vertex D. So wherever is the vertex B, your vertex D has to come because of the bigger triangle, B is 75 degree and for the smaller triangle at vertex D is 75 degree. So since B is in the center of this first triangle, D will also come in the center of the name of the second triangle. Now one vertex is common, that is C. C is there for ABC also and for this smaller triangle here also. So C is at the third place. So here also you will put it here. So remaining is E. You may have your own way of writing one-to-one correspondence, but see to it that you write it correctly. So now, first is to write the names correctly according to one-to-one correspondence. So ABC and triangle EDC. Let's see by what test are they congruent. We know one thing, that is angle ABC is congruent to angle EDC. Okay? The reason they have already given measure angle ABC is equal to measure angle EDC, which is equal to 75 degree. Okay, which is already given. Now, as I said that we have to see whether we can get any other angle which is congruent, then we can say that the triangles are similar by AA test of similarity. Yes. You can see here C angle is common. So here we can write angle ACB. ACB is congruent to angle ECD. Okay. If you write correct one-to-one correspondence, you don't even need to look at the figure. So angle ACB and angle ECD. They are congruent. And the reason you will give here is common angle. Therefore, we can write triangle ABC is similar to triangle EDC. Okay? By AA test of similarity. Okay, students, so state which two triangles are similar. So we stated here triangle ABC is similar to triangle EDC. And by which test? So by AA test of similarity. Now the further question is, write the similarity of these two triangles by a proper one-to-one correspondence. So yes, we have written the triangles are similar and we have also written one-to-one correspondence. I hope you have understood this sum. Now let's proceed to the second sum. Are the triangles in figure 1.56 similar? If yes, by which test? Look at the figure first. PQR and LMN. If you look at the figure in triangle PQR and LMN, we have to prove that, we have to see whether the triangles are similar and by what test. Now we have studied the test for similarity. And there we have studied AA test, SAS, and SSS test for similarity. Now, among these tests, Whatever given information is there in this question, we can see that there are three sides of one triangle and the three sides of another triangle. So we will see whether SSS test of similarity is possible here. For that, we have to take the ratio of the sides. So in both the triangles, we will take the ratio of the sides of both the triangles. So PQ upon LM. So what is PQ upon LM? PQ is given 6, LM is given 3. And if you reduce, 3 ones are, 3 twos are, so 2 upon 1. Then we will see the next side, that is we can take PR. If we take PR, then we have to take LN. So PR is 10 and LN is 5. Again, if we reduce, 5 ones are, 5 twos are, so 2 upon 1. Now, the remaining, the third side, QR. If we take QR, then QR upon MN. Okay, so QR is given 8, MN is given 4. So with this, 4 ones are, 4 twos are. If you observe that the three ratios, they are equal. Okay, from this 1, 2 and 3, we can write PQ upon LM is equal to PR upon LN is equal to QR upon MN. Why did I write this statement? Because all the three ratios, you can see that they are equal to 2 upon 1. Therefore, I can write this ratio equal to this ratio equal to this ratio. And since the sides are in proportion of both the triangles, we can write that triangle PQR is similar, therefore triangle PQR is similar to triangle LMN by SSS test of similarity. Is it clear, students? They had given two triangles. Okay, and they had given the three sides of both the triangles and we had to check whether they are similar and by which test. So since three sides were given, we took the ratios and we found that the ratio is equal. Therefore, we write this, that is, the three ratios are equal and therefore, by SSS test of similarity, the triangles are similar. I hope you have understood this second sum. Let's proceed to the third sum. Now let's begin with the third sum. As shown in figure 1.57, two poles of height 8 meter and 4 meter are perpendicular to the ground. If the length of shadow of smaller pole due to sunlight is 6 meter, then how long will be the shadow of the bigger pole at the same time? They have also given the figure PRQ ACB. These are the two triangles given. Okay. Now, PR is one pole, AC is another pole. PR is a smaller pole, AC is a bigger pole. And these poles are perpendicular to the ground. They have already given. Poles are always perpendicular to the ground. I have put a perpendicular sign here. Now the smaller pole PR makes a shadow of 6 meter. So QR is the shadow of PR, which is 6 meter. And we have to find the shadow of this AC pole. So we have to find BC. BC is a shadow of AC. So we have to find BC. Okay. Now, if you look at the figures here, there are two triangles. When we can get this X? If you see, these are the sides. If we know that the sides are in proportion, we can put these values, okay? And from this four values, if we know these three, we can find the fourth. So first we have to find the sides are in proportion. So to bring this statement that the sides are in proportion, we have to first prove that the triangles are similar. So how you will prove the triangles are similar? By which test? Now there are three tests which we know: AAA test, or which is also called as AA test, SAS test or SSS. So which is applicable here? SSS means we need three sides which we don't have. Now SAS, side angle side, side angle side, but we don't know this side, so we cannot prove by side angle side. So look at AA test. We know one angle, that this is perpendicular, so they both are 90 degrees, so we can prove that one angle is congruent. From we need one more angle. Now here if you read the statement, the how long will be the shadow of the bigger pole at the same time? The shadow is cast for PR and at the same time the shadow is cast at AC. Always remember students, when a shadow is cast at the same time, it makes congruent angle. Okay, it makes congruent angle at those objects on which it forms a, of which it forms the shadow. So here PR and AC, they are forming the shadow. And the shadow is cast at the same time. Therefore, this angle is congruent to this angle. So always remember, when the shadow is cast at the same time, they make congruent angles. And therefore, we can use this information to prove the triangles are similar by AA test. Okay, so we start. Okay, so we know that PR is perpendicular to QR and AC is perpendicular to BC. Therefore, we know that angle PRQ is congruent to angle ACB, which is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, now if we take in triangle PRQ and triangle ACB. Okay, angle PRQ is congruent to angle ACB. The reason you will write, each is 90 degrees. And second you will write, angle RPQ is congruent to angle CAB. RPQCAB. Reason, shadows cast at the same time. Okay, so now we can write, therefore triangle PRQ is similar to triangle ACB by AA test of similarity. Okay, after proving that the triangles are similar by AA test of similarity, we will write the sides are in proportion. So PR upon AC, PR upon AC is equal to RQ upon CB. RQ upon CB is equal to PQ. PQ upon AB. Reason, corresponding sides of similar triangle. You can write the short form. That is corresponding sides of similar triangle. Okay, we are talking about similar triangles. Now, whatever lengths we know, we are going to substitute. Okay, so PR we know that is 4. Then AC, you know it is 8. RQ is 6. BC we don't know and it is given X. Okay. And PQ and AC, AB sorry, is not given. So now, here you will see that 4 upon 8 is equal to 6 upon 8. Since this ratio we don't know anything, we will not take this. We will take only the first and the second. So 4 upon 8 is equal to 6 upon x. We just cross multiply. 4 into x is equal to 6 into 8. Okay. We have taken the first and the second. And we just cross multiply. And therefore, x is equal to 6 into 8 upon 4. So here, 4 ones are, 4 twos are. Therefore, x is equal to 12 meters. But what is x? What they have asked us to find? How long will be the shadow of the bigger pole? Okay, so we need to write the answer. Therefore, the shadow of the bigger pole, we'll write the length, okay? The length of the length of the shadow of the bigger pole is 12 meters. I hope you have understood this sum. We proceed. To the fourth sum. In triangle ABC, AP is perpendicular to BC. BQ perpendicular to AC. B dash P dash C. A dash Q dash C. Then prove that triangle CPA similar to triangle CPQ CQB if AP is 7, BQ is 8, BC is 12, then find AC. Look at the figure. Perpendicular signs are already given. Okay. Then B dash P dash C and A dash Q dash C. Yes, we have to prove that the triangles are similar. Which two triangles? Look at the triangle C P A and triangle C Q P. Okay, and further after finding the triangles are similar, they have given the further things to do. So let's first prove that the triangles are similar. Now here,
in triangle CPA. CPA. And triangle CQB. Why I'm reading it again? You need to first check that the names what are given, whether they are according to one-to-one correspondence. If they are not according to one-to-one correspondence, sometimes they don't give according to one-to-one correspondence and you need to check. So always write the name of the triangle according to their one-to-one correspondence. So how you will check that? If you look at both the triangles, C is common. So C is written first here and here also first. Then there is 90 degree at P angle and there is 90 degree at Q angle, which is written at center and center, yes, and the third letter. Now, by which test can we prove that the two triangles are similar? We don't know anything about the sides. So let's go to AA test only. So we know that one angle, these two angles are 90 degree. Okay, that is here, this angle CPA and angle CQB. And there is a common angle, angle C. So we can prove that the triangles are similar by which test? AA test of similarity. So we write angle CPA congruent to angle CQB. Reason here is each is 90 degree. And you can then write angle PCA. So you can write PCA. PCA congruent to angle QCB. Okay? QCB. Reason you will write here. Common angle. Therefore, triangle CPA similar to triangle CQB by AA test of similarity. Okay. So we have proved the first thing, that the triangles are similar. They have said if the triangles are similar, further AP is 7, BQ is 8, BC is 12 and then you find AC. Now, how we will get these sides? Only when we write the sides are in proportion. When the triangles are similar, the sides are in proportion and the angles are congruent. So here we'll write the sides are proportional, that is CP upon CQ is equal to PA upon QB is equal to CA upon CB. Okay. So, corresponding sides of similar triangle. Out of this, whatever value here are given, we will substitute. CP is not given, so we keep it as it is. CQ also, we will keep it as it is. PA is given, that is AP is given, which here we have written as PA. This one and the same, that is 7. BQ is given 8, so this is QB, which is one and the same, that is 8 here. CA we have to find, AC. And CB, that is BC, 12. Okay. Now, we need to take the second and the third ratio. So, we have just substituted the values here. Okay. Now, here if you see the second and the third ratio, we will take, we will not take the first. So, second and third ratio, if we take it is 7 upon 8 is equal to CA upon 12. Just cross multiply. Okay, therefore, CA is 7 into 12 upon 8. I shift this 8 on the other side. Okay, 4 2s are 4, 3s are 12. Therefore, CA is equal to 21 upon 2. Therefore, what we'll get the answer as? CA is equal to 10.2. 5. Clear? Now we proceed with the next sum here, the fifth one. In trapezium PQRS, so PQRS is a trapezium, okay? Side PQ is parallel to SR. Given is AR is 5 times AP and AS is 5 times AQ. Prove that SR is 5 times PQ. Okay. Now, this is a trapezium here. We know the property of a trapezium that one pair of the side is parallel, which is given. So, we start quadrilateral P. Q R S is a trapezium. Okay, if a side PQ parallel to side SR. Okay, now look at this given information. AR is equal to 5 AP. This can be converted into a ratio. That is AR upon AP is equal to 5 upon 1. AS upon AQ is equal to 5 upon 1. So something about a ratio. So let's see that whether we can prove the two triangles similar here. Now, since we have to prove this PQ and SR. See here, SR is equal to 5 PQ. So we want PQ and SR. Let's take these two triangles. That is triangle PAQ and triangle RAS. Okay, we have to prove these two triangles similar. Now, again here, we will see by which test there are nothing is given about the sides. So, we have to see for the angles. These two triangles are forming this vertically opposite angle here. Okay, so this one angle we have got congruent. And they have given this is a trapezium. So, we know the parallel lines of a trapezium. And if this one diagonal here, QS or PR, any one of this, acts as a transversal. We know when the lines are parallel, alternate angles are congruent. Here, it is forming a Z, which forms the alternate angles. So, we can prove the alternate angles are congruent. And then we can prove these two triangles are similar by AA test of similarity. Okay, so let's proceed. Since PQ is parallel to SR, and if we take QS as a transversal, PQ parallel to SR, and if QS is a transversal, two parallel lines, they form alternate angles with the transversal. So, which alternate angles here we'll get? This angle here and this angle here. You can even take PR as a transversal. If you take PR as a transversal, this angle will be congruent to this angle here. Okay, since we have taken QS as transversal, so what will happen? Angle PQS is congruent to angle RSQ. PQS congruent to RSQ. Okay, reason you will write alternate angle theorem. Now look at this angle, PQS. Instead of this PQS, I can also write as PQA because I want to take the small triangles. So I will take, instead of PQS, I will write PQA with this one and the same angle, PQA. And instead of RSQ, RSQ, I will write as RSA. The reason is Q dash A dash S or when we talk about this angle here, we say that Q dash A dash S. When you talk about this angle here, you can say that P dash A dash R. Or the reason you can give same angles with different names. Okay. Whether it is PQS or PQA, it is one and the same angle. Whether it is RSQ or RSA, it is one and the same angle. So you can give this reason or you can say same angles with different names. You can put this as one. Now we go to the triangles. We name the triangles. Which two triangles we said we will take? That is triangle PQA and triangle RSA. Okay. PQA and triangle RSA. In these two triangles, we have already said that these are vertically opposite angles and these two angles we just now proved alternate angles. Therefore, the two triangles are similar by a test of similarity that we will write here. That in these two triangles, angle PAQ congruent to angle RAS. PAQ congruent to RAS. Reason, vertically opposite angles. Okay, here PAQ RAS. Now, after this, we will take this PQA congruent to RSA from 1. Just now we proved, no? And since these two angles are congruent, we can write triangle PQA similar to triangle RSA by a test of similarity. Okay, but this is not what is asked. So we will write the sides are in proportion. So PQ upon RS is equal to QA upon SA is equal to PA upon RA. So PQ upon RS is equal to QA upon SA is equal to PA upon RA. Corresponding sides of similar triangle. Now they have given us here two things. That is AR is phi AP and AS is phi AQ. This is given. Okay, we substitute. Whatever we can, we will substitute. Nothing about PQ and RS is given. Okay. Now, here, QA. Again, nothing about QA. But AS is given, SA. AS and SA are same. So we'll write QA as it is. And AS is phi AQ. So AS is this. Instead of AS, we'll write phi AQ. Okay, which is equal to, again here nothing about AP is given. So we write it as it is. But RA or AR, they have given about AR. Okay, so RA और ए आर इज इक्वल टू फाइव ए पी. क्यू ए एंड ए क्यू इज वन एंड द सेम. पी ए एंड ए पी इज वन एंड द सेम. इफ यू वॉन्ट यू कैन मेक इट प्रॉपर योर इन द नेक्स्ट स्टेप. योर यू कैन राइट दिस एज क्यू ए and you can make this as, so AP and PA is the same, AQ and QA is the same. So now QA, QA gets cancelled, AP, AP gets cancelled. So what do we get? We get PQ upon RS is equal to 1 upon 5 is equal to 1 upon 5. So this ratio is equal to 1 upon 5. Now we just cross multiply, so we get 5PQ is equal to RS. Okay, instead of RS we can write SR also. Okay, so this is, I will write the other way. Here SR is equal to 5PQ. Because this is the way it is asked. SR is equal to 5PQ. We have to prove this. Okay, so here instead of RS, I wrote SR is equal to 5PQ. I just reversed it. Okay, this is asked to root, which is root. I hope you all are clear.
Homework. Revise the test of similarity of triangles and the properties of similar triangle. Students, complete the practice set 1.3 sums which were taught in this video. Thank you.